Okay, and welcome back. I'm going to finish talking about dummy terms in synthetic division. And let's go ahead and put these steps back up for you here in case you didn't see them in the last videos. And let me start off with this problem here. Let's say you have x squared plus 1. Okay, well, when you're dividing, what you're going to end up doing when you're dividing synthetically, what you're going to end up doing is put dummy terms in place of where the missing terms of x are. So in this case here, there's an x squared plus a 1. Well, there should be an x here, and then the 1 would come after that. So rewrite it like this, inserting your dummy terms. X squared plus 0x, where this is your dummy term, okay? And you finish it up by inputting this last one here, plus 1. Okay, so let me move this up a little bit. So what you're going to have now is this. Your coefficient of 1 here, 0, and this is just a 1. So you're going to have 1, 0, 1. Now, let's say that for this particular problem, we're dividing it by something simple, x minus 1. Okay, so set this up here. You take the opposite of this constant here, which is 1, and what you're going to do is set this up and bring down the 1. 1 times 1 is just 1. 0 and 1 is 1. 1 times 1 is 1. And 1 plus 1 is 2. So your answer is going to be starting off with 1 degree less than what you started off in your original polynomial. So if this is x squared, this is going to start off with just x. And you bring down the 1, and this will be plus your remainder, 2 over x minus 1. Okay, so that was pretty easy. But let's say you had something a little more difficult. What if somebody gave you a problem, and we're not going to work this one out. I have other examples, but I'm just going to try to explain this to you in case you're not understanding how this dummy term works, because there's other problems that a little more difficult. Like, I'll give you an example. Let's say you just had x squared over x minus 1. In that case, the dummy terms here would be this. You'd have x squared plus, you'd have to put in, let's use a different color, plus 0x plus 0. Okay? The reason why is because you don't have a term, you don't have an x term here, and you don't have the constant, it's missing. You just have the x squared, so you have to put in plus 0x plus 0. So basically, you want it to take this form. Ax to, in this case here, I'm not going to be too general, I'm just going to say, like, let's just say to the fourth. So that means that the next term would be like bx cubed plus cx squared plus dx plus a number, you know, let's just say n, you know. So you have 4, 3, 2, 1, and there's an x to the 0 here, but we don't write that. It's just customary to just, you know, it'll end up being 1. Anything to the 0 power is 1, so, I mean, this basically turns into a 1, and so it's customary just to write the n. Okay, now if you're still not seeing it quite that, it's not obvious, you're not seeing it quite that simply, then I'm going to show you an intuitive way to kind of look at it. We'll leave this up here. We'll leave this ax to the fourth, bx cubed. Let's say we were missing this term here, and we were missing this term here. Okay? Let's pretend that here's God, the Almighty, and here's you. Let's say you need stairs to get to him, right? So since we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 steps, it's going to take you 5 steps to get there. So let's just, let's see. So 1 step, 2 steps, 3 steps, 4 steps, 5 steps, right? And you have the fourth power here. So let's say you have, let's start off over here. X to the fourth. This would be x cubed. This would be x squared. This would be x to the 1 and x to the 0. In reality, here, this a, b, c, d, and the n right here, this is basically your n, because remember, this is just 1, which is really going to be, in this case here, if n was in here, it would just be the n times 1. So to make more sense of this, let's say, for instance, you had this. Let's say you did have a problem that was like this. 2x to the 4th plus, we're missing this term, so let's go to the next one, plus, instead of cx squared, we'll have 3x squared, plus, instead of dx, we'll have just x, and in this case here, well, actually, we're missing the dx, right? So we're gonna, let's take that out, and let's just call that, in that case, we have the constant term here, we're leaving out the dx, so there's not going to be an x here. So let's just put, for n, let's just say that it's a 4. Okay, so this is basically the polynomial, 2x to the 4th plus 3x squared plus 4. Okay, so over here, basically, if you're following these kind of steps, what's missing is the cube, and you're missing the single x term, the term that has x to the 1 power. Okay, so in this case here, you would actually have 2x to the 4th. We're missing the cube one, but we have a 3x squared. We're missing this term, and we have the 4 over here, right? So what's happening is, basically, if these are the steps, okay, you're missing this term here and this term here. So this is where you insert your dummy terms. So this would be plus 0x cubed, and this would just be plus 0x. Okay? So that's basically kind of what's happening here. So I got time to do one problem. And I'll go ahead and explain this next problem to you. Let me get rid of some of this stuff here. I guess we can do without that right there. Okay. So let's do this problem over here. What if we have something kind of simple? How about this one? 2x squared minus 1 all over x minus 2. Well, first of all, set this up opposite. This is going to be 2x squared plus 0x minus 1. So my coefficient is going to be 2, 0, negative 1. And let's set this up. Bring down the 2. 2 times 2 is 4. 0 and 4 is just 4. 2 times 4 is 8. 8 and negative 1 is 7. So my answer is going to be 1 degree less, so it's going to be 2x plus 4 plus 7 over x minus 2. Okay, so I'm gonna do another video, actually, that has some more examples, more difficult than this, because you need practice with these. So check out the next video on this, and thanks for watching.